doing all the, she's going to clean all the legs of the tables and chairs that were not after the edge clean. So now once it knows that it's finished doing its edge clean, it will find edge clean and the legs of the tables and chairs clean. So then it will find the shortest way home, and that's home. And this is Roomba. So now, I think it was finding his shortest way home. And to know whether it's going home, by looking at the Roomba or phone, the home light will be flashing. The home light will be flashing. And then, and you can see in the app also, it will come that it's returning home. So you can see it's like a virtual wall around the base, so it can't ever touch the base like this. This is cleaning all legs of the tables and chairs, all the legs of the tables and chairs. And now I think it's going to come to the room and clean the legs of that bed. So I'm sorry if my voice is not so clear because of the Roomba sound, but I'll try to make it clear. Now I hope you can see, there's the home flashing light which it automatically put, and now it's going home. So now I'll show you, it's taking the shortest way home, and it'll make a nice sound when it goes home. So now it has cleaned everywhere, it has not missed a spot that I can see. It's not missed a single spot, so now it's going under the bed because it's like the shortest way home instead of going whole round. So here it's coming. And now it's going to align itself with its base. So now here is where that sensor in front helps. And aligned. So now as you can see, since it has lost a lot of battery, there's now the red sign on. So here's LiDAR sensor. And I'll open the bin and show you how much thing is going. Oh wow, look, I can see the message. Roomba successfully finished cleaning. I'll be showing you edge clean. Now you have seen how the home button works. It automatically put it this time. Manually also you can put, so I'll be showing you spot clean next. Now I'll be doing spot cleaning. First press on clean to just switch it on. Now press spot clean. So now it will go in a circle of a large diameter.
Everything here in this circle, everything, like there's a bit of a dirty spot there. It doesn't leave anything, but just to show you I'm doing this. So if there's any place really dirty which you want to clean and you don't want to clean the whole house, then you can do this. So it's going in a full round, and it does it very quickly also. So now it will come back to the center and it will spin like this and complete. So now I'll show you how the home mode works.
I have kept it in front of its home base, and now I'm gonna click home. So now it's going home.
So now I'll show you its dustbin.
There's a Roomba on his base, and I'll be putting the photos of the map which it has created. So now I'll show you its dustbin. So now I'm just taking out the dustbin. It's really easy. And whoa! You won't imagine how much dust is there. This is how much. So So I'm showing you. This is how much dust we got. Now let's empty the dustbin and I'll show you how to remove the filter.
Here is the dustbin. You can see there's a lot of dirt. So just you can remove this door also, it's removable. Here it's gone in the dustbin. So you may have to shake it a bit. And now I'll show you how to remove the filter. Clean the filter. And use a brush. You can just tap
the filter. So now you just have to tap it and then all the dust on the filter will come out. You can use a brush, you can use whatever you want.
And now just put it like this back. It will be horizontal. And then put it.
And this is the underside of the Roomba. These are the rollers which do the deep cleaning of carpets. Here's the battery. You'll have to pull it out if you're buying it. And here is the nozzle wheel. So here you have to remove this like this. And a bit of hair might be there. So you can just remove it like this. And now you can remove the wheel by just pulling it. So you have to just push it from here. And it will come out. It's like very easy to maintain. So there might be some dust here. You can, this is the axle, so just remove whatever dust you find.
The nozzle wheel, I'll just put it back like this. There's a slight crack, and if it's spinning properly, that means you have attached it properly. And just put it in. And here the brush, I'll show you that afterwards. So here, these are the rollers, which the first time you might find it really hard to do it. So these are the two yellow things. Press it, open it. And if you ever remove both rollers at the same time, don't worry, because there's marking here, as you can see which rollers where. So these are dual rollers. So here you have to remove this cap and see if there's any dirt here. And then the other side here, so there's no dirt here, so I'll just keep this here. So here there's some hair, so as you can see there's a lot of hair caught up here. So this side also there's some hair. So if you have lots of pets, you might have to do this maintenance a bit more regularly. So now see, I am now mixing this up, but still there's marking, so I know where to put it. And also there's a shape, the shapes here, so you can see. And this also, this is the sensor over here, which makes dirt events if it finds too much dirt. And here is the vacuum port, which leads to the dustbin. So now just put the rollers in like this. Put this here, rotate it a bit so that it comes in the correct order. Because it is like a shape over here which you have to follow. So just spin it a bit and here it comes in. Here also, just spin it a bit and it will come in. And now close this. So here is the brush. So as you can see, maximum hair is here. So I have a screwdriver. They made the screw thick enough so you can use a coin. The screw driver, you can use coin, you can use to open this. So just open it enough to pull out the brush. Don't open it too much, otherwise it will be a bit hard to put it back. So after just unscrewing it a bit, just you have to pull the brush. So just unscrew it a bit more, and here it's totally unscrewed. Now just pull out the brush. As you can see, there's a lot of hair tangled up in the brush. You get replacement brushes also once the old brushes are worn and torn. Here
you might get a lot of tangles if you have pets, but you have to do the maintenance only once a month if you are just alone. Now I'll put the screw back. You don't have to worry how much you're tightening the screw, because the brush moves along with the screw, so you don't need to concentrate much. And I will also now show you the clip sensors. As you can see, these are the clip sensors. This, and this. And these are the wheels of the Roomba which go down. So when it goes down, the Roomba knows that it is being placed on the ground. This is the mapping sensor over here, as you can see. And here are the two charging things which align to the charger. And this is the bumper. So this is all the maintenance you have to do. That do not so often. And you can also wipe the top of the Roomba once in a while. Hey everyone, I hope you enjoyed this video. I know it might be a bit too long, but I hope you enjoyed the review of the Roomba. And the model is 900 series, and the exact number is 976. Thank you. I forgot to tell you one thing. That is, you should never allow your Roomba to go near even a drop of water, so that it won't get spoiled. Okay, bye everyone, and I'll see you in my next video.